Yes.
This is Shubhashini Parthasarthy from D5, MF23. So today I thought that I will try to let you know about the lift, which one is being used here. So but the lift is right now in the second floor, and I would like to go to the, I want that to come to the first floor. So I try to press this. So the lift is coming down. So as it is coming down, I will show you there is a small key that is in triangular shape, which is provided in the door. I will let you know what it is about. Now when we are trying to get inside the lift, most of us, we would not have seen the sensors. The sensor is this. The black thing that you are seeing, you will be seeing the two lights here. On both the sides, you know, this light is provided, and there is a line. The light rays are going between this and the other side. You are able to see the lights here. So these things will be telling you that, you know, somebody is inside or, you know, halfway through. So the doors are not going to collapse on you. So this is one fear people are having. Okay. Now the other fear that people are having is the gap that is there. Within this gap, yes, of course, you can drop your cell phone or any small item, or, you know, your keys. So be careful with that. But otherwise, when the lift service was going on, I just asked them to open that to see what is there under that. There are two springs and the other control panels, but otherwise no other animal or no insects are there. It is quite clean. Now when it comes to the sensor, once again we are trying to go into the lift and see that, you know, we are trying to go down, and this is Johnson, where maximum load is around 13 people and 84 kilograms. So don't try to overload the lift, because overloading is going to cause a lot of strain on the machine. And when we are trying to see, there is here phone. This one, there is one phone that is provided in the ground floor, which I will show you. When you press this, when you are inside, when you want to call somebody, you can always press this particular thing, so that, you know, anybody who listens to that, you know, can just try to pick up the phone and find out in which floor you are getting stuck. And if that is, nobody is there in the ground floor, then you can always press this, and, you know, this will give you an alarm. Whoever is passerby, perhaps, you know, will listen to this and then they will come. What is this button? This button is something to do with automatic and attender. AU is automatic and AT is attender. Now this is a non-stop. When this key, which is there with the maintenance, any emergency is there in the third floor or any other floor. Now when they want to reach the ground floor, and they want to reach the ground floor, this key will have to be put, and then it will be operated on this side, and then, you know, it will come to the attender mode. At that attender mode, when we are trying to press NS, which is something to do with a non-stop, in which case you see that, you know, the lift will not stop in between whoever is calling you. And this is, of course, the fan. You can always stop it. Now I have stopped it. There are two fans here, by the way, because, you know, this is here huge service thing where, you know, a stretcher can be easily accommodated inside. So once you get that, or, you know, people are going, you know, so many people, you know, you can accommodate 13 people. So 13 persons, when they are going, for the person who is standing at the rear side also, the fan will be there. So that is how, you know, the second fan is there. And the lights, they will try to switch off, you know, after some time when it is not in use, automatically. So that is a power saving method that is given. Even the fans will be switched off automatically after some time in the lift, without, you know, when it is not in operation condition. And there is a grip rail provided for the senior citizens to hold it and be stable. Here, of course, you know, all of us know this is ground floor, first floor, second floor, third floor. So you can always press that. This is for the door opening and the door closing. Okay, so door opening and door closing. So this much inside the cabin, inside the car. We call it lift car. Now there are instructions given, very clear instructions given as to what you are supposed to do when you are getting stuck or when you have to do it in both the languages, in Tamil and also in English. There was one more bigger font thing. This is a smaller font. A bigger font was provided by the lift people, which was tampered and totally damaged. So they had to remove it and they have put the safety warning again. So I don't know who is doing this. And there is a lot of damage that people have done it in this area with their keys. Whether they were nervous or they were just in a destruction mode, we don't know about it. So unless we safeguard what we are using, I don't think, when there is a difficulty, maybe the machine will try to ditch us. So one will have to be careful with that. So now I'll try to take you to the ground floor. Now you see automatically the fans are on and we are going down to the ground floor. So now we are in the ground floor and you see this one, what I was telling you about, that when you call up, this will try to ring. So I will tell you how it sounds. So that is the sound that you will be getting. And you can always, when you ring the bell, you can always take it and then you can try to speak to the person. You can try to speak to the person, find out which particular floor they are stuck. So that is regarding the phone. And when it comes to the alarm, how does it sound? It sounds like a beep. So anybody who is going on this side will be in a position to hear your siren and they will try to come out. Now what will happen when you are trying to be here and there is a power cut? When there is a power cut, you will be seeing a circle with a circle with a slash that there is no power, and it will give you a hint that don't panic, don't press anything, just stay put. And if the power comes, and whenever there is a power cut, if it is traveling, the lift car is traveling between two floors. So say for example, I am coming from ground floor to first floor, or ground floor to second floor, or first floor to second floor. When the lift is moving, it will be either between one and the other one. Okay, the two consecutive things. Take two consecutive numbers, wherever you are traveling, between that and the previous floor, whichever is closer, the battery is going to take the lift car, to the nearest floor. That instruction will be coming out and they will be telling that automatically inside the lift. All that you need to do is don't press anything here. Don't press any of these things. If you have sufficient space for your oxygen, you are not going to get exhausted, you are not going to get worried about it. Okay. So when it is happening and there is a power backup, it becomes easy for any person to come. Unless otherwise, if it is beyond a limit, then perhaps you can make use of the safety measures, either this or this. Press that to show that you are getting stuck. And what will happen when you are getting stuck? So that is one more question. So when we are getting stuck in between, say for example, the battery is not working, I am trying to open the door. The battery is not working and then you are getting stuck. nothing. Nothing is going to happen because there is a key here. And there is one triangular key which I will try to show you when we go to the maintenance department. So the screenshot I can always show you and tell you that is the, that is exactly the key what they will try to
just press and then put it and then turn. As you are turning that key, it will be like soda butti modi, okay, bottle opener type, okay. So you press that and then turn. And after turning, as you are turning, this will start moving, and then you need to just press that and then now move it, and then you can always take the person out. So that key, this key will be almost like a bottle opener, not like a normal chavi.
The normal key and the lift room key and also the key pertaining to this particular lift all are put in one particular keychain, and it is there in the maintenance department.
More thing I have to mention is, in the case of fire, do not use a lift, use a staircase.
Okay, fine. But then, are we in a position to tell everybody that they are not supposed to use the lift? Are they going to listen to that? Or are they going to run towards the lift?
What type of fire we should be cautious about? In case of fire, because a fire can be from any angle, from any direction, like, you know, it can be because of the gas leakage, it can be because of short circuit. So what exactly is this fire? So in case of fire, whatever may be that, do not use lift. It's a clear cut instruction. But in spite of that, those who have not seen it, or those who have not recorded this in our memory, or out of panic, you know, forgetting that, you know, there is something like this here, so they will be trying to take the lift.
So what to do at that point of time? So let us go find out what we will have to do when there is a fire. So they say that, you know, don't take the lift, take the stairs. But why should we take the stairs? Let us go and see. So nothing untoward can happen, but still, in the event of any fire, what are we supposed to do as an onlooker, or, you know, when we come to know? There is a provision for fire extinguisher here on both the sides. Both the sides we have the fire extinguisher. But then here, what is there in the left?
In the case of fire,
fine. So in the case of fire, they are asking us to break the glass.
There is a small glass here. Replacement of this glass is not going to cost much. But when there is a fire, we are supposed to break this open. It is thin glass, so you can always break it. And there is a switch there.
The switch will have to be switched off. So when you try to do that, once you switch off the particular switch, then you put it down, it gets switched off, and then nobody can use the lift, because you cannot keep telling people that, you know, don't use the lift, don't use the lift. You can't keep on repeating. And, you know, what if, you know, people are not going to listen to that, or, you know, whether you are not in a position to verbalize, best is, you know, to avoid the whole thing. So this is how, you know, the Johnson has designed the whole thing.